Hi, let me tell you something about this interesting device I recently made. It's actually a wirelessly controlled speaker system. And if you go to your electronics shop next door, you will find many high-end, very expensive brands offering these kind of technology for a few hundreds of euros. And actually, I was thinking this is too much, so I tried to figure it out how to make it myself. Now, what's inside this technology is actually one speaker, and I also took another speaker which is standing here, and I combined it with this smart electronic device right here. And this is a Raspberry Pi. Raspberry Pi is a small computer, and you can buy it on your favorite electronics website for 20-25 euros. And it actually translates the digital data that you send to it, the digital audio data to it, to an analog signal, which then is transmitted by the speakers right here. So you can easily send, with no effort, your song to the device and the speakers will play the song. Of course, this device doesn't look that nice, but you can easily put it somewhere behind the cupboard, because you don't have to interact with it. You don't have to hit buttons on it. The only button that you need to hit is actually the power button and the volume button right here of this speaker. By the way, the speaker, I took it from an old PC from back in the 90s. So it's really old technology, but the sound quality was very good. And that's the reason why I wanted to give it a second life. Now, if I zoom into this Raspberry Pi, this small computer right here, you will see a few cables are attached to it. First, you can see here the audio jack. So this is actually the sound card of the Raspberry Pi computer, and it produces the sound which goes to the speaker right here and to the other speaker on the other side of the television there. Another cable is the UTP cable for the network. So you hook up the device to the network somewhere, and your phone or iPad or tablet or computer or something will easily discover the Raspberry Pi and will see that it is a device where it can stream music to. Now, of course, you need to do some reconfiguration and a few programming tricks to make sure that the device works as you wanted it to work. So there is a little bit of software coding involved, but I'm sure if you have technical skills, you don't have to be an engineer, but you need to be technically interested, I'm sure that you will manage, because there are many tutorials on the internet how to program with and how to interact with the Raspberry Pi. I selected a few tutorials and I put it here on the bottom of this video, so you can easily start at least somewhere and try to figure out how you can configure this Raspberry Pi to work as a wirelessly controlled speaker system. Also, if you have questions, you can also contact me. And also contact the people that actually wrote the tutorials, because I'm only making a movie out of it. There are many other people that actually are directly involved with the tutorial. You can also contact them, I would say. Now, the software is put here on an SD card. You put it in the Raspberry Pi. You add a power supply cable. This is actually just a cable I took from an old cell phone, Samsung cell phone. You put it in the mains, and you will see that the LED starts blinking. That indicates that the device is actually working. So let me show you how I can stream my media to it. Well, I have an iPad right here, and all I need to make sure is that I select the right AirPlay device right here, which is actually already the case. So this means that the iPad is now transmitting all the audio data directly to this device right here. Now, and if I hit the play button of this song, it's actually one of these songs I like from 2014, you will hear that the song starts playing out of these speakers. So this is it. Now, I can also just put this here behind the cupboard. And actually, nobody needs to know that I didn't spend that much money for this kind of speaker system. This was the video. I hope you like it. If you like it, just hit the like button. And if you're in trouble making these kind of devices, you can easily contact